Hey guys, I'm Shelby Quintanilla.
And I'm Brad Martinez. And you're watching CSN. We'll be your anchors for this week's show.
We have a lot of interesting stories for you today, so stay tuned.
We have a great custodial staff here at Centennial High School.
That's right, Brad. We actually have a very clean campus, and I know a lot of us are very thankful for that.
That's right. So here's Alicia Hernandez to give us a little insight on one of our custodians.
It's funny how we can see somebody on a day-to-day basis and not know a thing about them, like their favorite color, their biggest fear, or even the little things like their shoe size. Never really taking the time to sit down and listen to someone's story. But who knows? It just might be an interesting story to tell.
Meet Kevin Kirker. He is one of the hardworking custodians here at Centennial. He has been involved with the custodian district for 6 years now and says he enjoys it.
I prefer it over fast food. You know, I've done that and it's not fun. It's a lot more challenging and it's harder work than this custodial gig. This job, you know, I have my benefits, I have paid vacation, you know, all the holidays that the students have, so I enjoy that as well.
Considering that Kevin is pretty young, only 25 years of age, he says he can really understand the high school atmosphere.
I can relate to the kids, the issues and everything that they go through, so it's a good setting for me.
You can say Kevin is a very popular face around here, but I bet you would have never guessed that he was also a very accomplished athlete. As a matter of fact, Kevin was offered a scholarship to college for cross country. So what exactly took this running man from breaking his sweat on a course to making the custodian plaza an everyday visit?
I did a lot of sports. I ran cross country, I wrestled, and what else did I do? I ran track as well. Cross country I did. I received a scholarship to NMSU. And I actually had a few offers from UNM and then from Texas, El Paso.
Unfortunately, due to too many injuries, Kevin was not able to endure any more running events. In a result, he lost his scholarships. Though he did have the opportunity to return, he decided that his legs were just too worn out to continue.
Once I wasn't able to run, school became kind of expensive. I was paying out of pocket. And so I just kind of, just a class here and there, I was able to really afford.
Though with Kevin's injury downfall, he never let that stop him from trying to move forward, as he tells us of his ambition to become a nurse.
One for my nursing degree, and that's my passion to, you know, be a nurse someday at pediatrics. I love working with kids, so, you know, that's the goal, to finish up and do that eventually.
Everybody has a story to tell, and Kevin Kirker's will be one to remember. Reporting for Centennial Student News, this has been Alicia Hernandez.
Many students don't know what they are planning to do after high school, so to help out with that, the career fair came to our school to encourage the junior class.
Centennial High's juniors got to walk around and meet with a lot of different people in a variety of different jobs, such as Border Patrol, the Air Force, medical lab techs, and almost any job you can dream of. So we got the details of why they chose their job and why they want to inspire students to do it as well.
I was really interested in science and biology. I had scored high enough on my testing, my ACTs and everything, that my choices were science.
Well, I want to come out here and encourage students to do the same job as me, because what I do is important, and I get to go out and see the world, and I've got to do stuff that I know my kids are going to read about in their history books, and their kids will do the same as well.
After high school, actually, this wasn't my career. My career was computers. And what I did was I went to college, got my degree, got into computers. And shortly after that, I decided to be in law enforcement just to kind of help out people. And I think just working for the government for such a long time as being a computer guy, I also wanted to be a law enforcement for government also.
We also asked students if they have an idea of what they want to be and if the career fair changed their outlook on all the jobs that are really out there.
I change my mind almost every single day about what I want to be when I grow up, but hopefully I'll figure it out soon.
I thought about what I wanted to be. I think probably going to the military after college. career fair has affected me with my choice, because I didn't think cruises was, I thought cruises was just like simple things in here, and it's actually, there's actually pretty interesting things in here.
This has been Mariah Quintana for Centennial Student News.
With friends and extracurricular activities, it's kind of hard to keep up with everything, and we kind of lose sight of what we're actually here at school for.
That's right, we're here for an education. And as an incentive to help us do well, our administration has put in place a mandatory grade point average in order for us to have the privilege to go off campus.
That's right, Brad. Here's Kaylin Archip with more information on that.
Hey, Hawks. As you know, a lot of kids aren't able to go off campus for lunch, and I'm here to give you the story. Students work hard to make the 3.0 GPA requirements in order to go off campus for lunch, but some aren't able to meet it. Let's see what Mrs. Stewart has to say.
If you don't have the 3.0, then I don't think you should be allowed, because it's really not that hard to maintain a 3.0 and just pass your classes. So I think it should be a gift.
Do you know what your current GPA is?
Yes, my current semester GPA is 4.1.
Yes, my grade point average is a 2.0.
How do you maintain your high grade point average?
I try and connect everything I'm learning to things that I'm interested in, and then as far as homework goes, I like to stay in stress-free environments, kind of like this library.
With regards to the open and closed campus regulation with the school district, all the schools, all the high schools, are specifically a closed campus. I know that some schools are able to monitor their campus a lot better. Centennial probably has the best monitoring because of our location and the facility and the things that we have as assets. But bottom line, the school district has a regulation that we, the administration, teachers, and the security guards have to uphold as part of our jobs and responsibilities.
Well, there you have it, our school's thoughts on the GPA requirements in order to go off campus for lunch. I'm Kaylin Archrip, reporting for Centennial Student News.
We'll be right back with sports after this quick commercial break.
And I'm Brianna Rodriguez.
And this is your Hawk Sports Network.
So Marina, for being a first year school, we have some pretty amazing football players.
So I've heard. Even some of our guys got all district.
Well, you've heard correct. Here are some of our very own 2012 all district players talking about how they feel about being an all district player.
It feels good being getting the accomplishment for all district second team. I couldn't have done it without my team, from the linebackers to the DN and the linemen and the defensive backs, and with the coaches' help and all the work that paid off during the offseason.
Being an all-district player really means a lot to all of us. Like Adrian said, like, it wasn't for like anybody on the line or so. It just really feels good to be an all-district player, just knowing that you could go an all-state next year, so hopefully that'll help us next year working harder and being an all-state player.
Feels pretty good. I couldn't do it without my team, my team's help. Next year, we all want to try to make it on there somehow and to be like all state players or something. And we're just going to keep working hard until we achieve our goals.
To be all district for both sides of the ball, that's something I've been working on my life, like to thank my coaches and my team.
It feels good to be all district because we've all worked hard, I've worked hard, everybody's worked hard who got all district, and I want to thank my coaches and everybody who supported us, even the students at Centennial High
School. Wow, Marina, that is a lot of work those guys have put in this season.
I know, all of us would be so proud of them.
Well, here is your official 2012 all district players.
Matt Alvarez, Jerry Girola, Adrian Garcia, Andres Chavez, Joaquin Melendez, and Christian Sedeno.
Both basketball teams are doing an amazing job in their season. For girls basketball, they are 1-1.
As for boys basketball, they are also having an amazing season.
The boys' basketball is now 3-0. They have an away game tonight against Fabens.
Well, come check them out on December 11th at home against Hot Springs High School.
Good luck.
Here are your players of the week.
The player of the week for girls' basketball is Asia Jones.
And your boys' basketball player of the week is Cesar Molina.
Congratulations. Wrestling has officially started. Here is Zach Montoya talking about the wrestling season.
I think we're going to do really good. We've worked really hard.
Wrestling has been working very hard since the summer, which is obvious because they placed second in last week's tournament.
Marina, what are you doing?
I don't know.
They don't want to see you anymore. No. All right, well, that's it for this week's show.
Check you guys later.
Bye.
I think that's Edward Collins.
He's so spicy.
I know what you are.
Say it. Say it out loud.
A vampire.
No, I'm an albino. Ah, you should have seen the look on your face.
Anchoring for CSN.
Yeah, and next time we'll have some fun holiday stuff for you guys. I'm Brad Martinez.
And I'm Shelby Quintanilla. Thanks for watching.
Have a great day.